press blah to tap the apple. Well, okay, I guess a button will work, but for some reason, I feel like I should be using a touchscreen for that. See you later, Apple. Have fun in the endless abyss.
Meow. What are you doing here? Are you lost too? Well, I don't have anything to give you, so run along and find somewhere else to beg. Purr. I don't think he's too happy with you right now. Where am I? Well, I'm not too sure, but we can use the left stick to move. Welcome everybody to a brand new Let's Play. This is Gravity Rush Remastered. This was originally released on the PlayStation Vita, but, since nobody has a PlayStation Vita except for, like, me and five other people, they decided to do a remaster for the PlayStation 4. And it's pretty awesome. They did a lot of upgrades. They made it 1080p, 60fps, which is a big deal because it was like 500-something p and it usually ran at like 20fps before. So they did a major upgrade. They also included like all the DLC. And this game is just, overall, it's really awesome. And I like it a whole lot, so I decided to do a Let's Play of it. Especially because I like doing 100% Let's Plays, and doing 100% in this game is not very difficult or time-consuming. I expect this Let's Play to be about 30, maybe a little bit more, in terms of episodes, so yeah. Without further ado, let's get along with the story by walking through this door. And suddenly a zombie appears, but actually not really. Episode 1, From Oblivion. Let go. Please, I need... Yeah, even if it's an emergency, you probably shouldn't just grab random people. Bother someone else. Wait, you don't understand. You gotta save my boy. Your boy? What's wrong? Is he in trouble? He's this way, come on. Alright, well, we'll just follow this mysterious man. And the game auto-saves, which is great because you can't... Actually, you can't have a real solid save until you finish episode 3. Which is not very hard to get to, you can get there in less than an hour. But still, it would be great if you could save after episode 1. So, yeah, as you can tell, they're not speaking English, and they're not speaking Japanese. They're speaking a made-up language called Gravanese, and it's kind of a combination of, French and English and Spanish and Japanese and, all this other stuff. Also, I like this first-person perspective where you can use the motion controls on the PS4 controller. I don't know. Some people would call it immersive, but I don't usually use words such as that, because I'm more about the fun than the immersion. Very rarely do I get immersed into anything, because I'm always looking at the screen and I'm just yeah, I'm looking at a screen, I'm not actually there.
Yuji!
Well, he sure is in a predicament. What's going on? You saw him up there. My joy is... My boy's trapped in that house, not my joy. I guess it is his pride and joy. That's what some people call their children or whatever. He'll be taken away by the storm. But what am I supposed to do? You're like that crow girl, right? Use your cat, get up there and save him. I don't think cats can do that. Crow girl? What crow girl? Drop the act. I saw you plunge from the sky without a scratch. Use that superpower of yours and get my boy. Superpower. And I love this part so much. The cat starts glowing. Galaxy cat, to the rescue. And where are you going? Just turn around and look at me, okay. But this part's hilarious. I don't have any superpowers. And then she immediately just flies into the sky. I don't know, I just thought that was really funny. Every time I see that, it's funny. I don't have superpowers, and then you just start floating. Alright, I'm standing on a wall? Question mark? Did you do this? Meow probably means yes. So, yeah, this is the main mechanic of Gravity Rush, controlling gravity. And it's a really cool mechanic. Man, the thing about this game is that it feels like an indie game if an indie game had, millions of dollars for a budget. Things are not looking good for that random child, who will totally not be important to the story at all. Except he kind of will. But yeah, so now we can actually control gravity instead of letting the game control it for us. And it's very simple, actually. Now at first, it's really awkward. You're like, how do I do this? And everyone who starts out, pretty much everyone, they're just really disoriented. And it's understandable because most games do not give you this level of platforming control. Is it a platformer if you can fly half the time? I don't know. What is a platformer? But yeah, you just use one button to float and then press it again to go in that direction. And as we can see, there's a hand of death coming out of that black hole. Even though black holes can't do that because, event horizons are a thing. Not that most of you know what that is. I mean, I wouldn't blame you because it's kind of not
a well-known thing, but anyways, yeah, you can just use the X button to jump. There are points where you're going to want to jump and not actually fly. Some points where you actually just can't fly at all. And now we must do what that cop hoped to do and then died trying. We'll save this boy. Insert Metal Gear Solid reference here. And here. What did you do? I didn't. I asked you to save my boy, not destroy my house. Give our house back. But it wasn't my fault. I was trying to stop it from falling. Great job you did of that. I know I shouldn't have trusted a gravity shifter. Bunch of good-for-nothing troublemakers. All Mom's things were in that house. You have to bring it back now. But, you know, I'm pretty sure it's just like, I think there's ground beneath there. You could probably just go and get it yourself. I didn't do anything wrong. You did nothing wrong. Hey, where are you going? Shifters, all rotten. You said it, Pops. Wow, they're like, they're not very friendly, are they? What was I supposed to do? I was only trying to help. And you did help. You saved that kid, but he turned out to be kind of a terrible person. What is it? You see something? It's a door. With a light. A door? What's behind door number one? Out of one. Turn that handle, and then kick it a few times.
Là, je suis ma cheville. Et je crois plein sa fille chez tout ainsi. Plein jeu de. Plein s'habillement de la sapin chauffée. De blessant ma. L'ouetterie. Chaplain tout le savait.
What are you anyway? Were you the one changing gravity? Purr. What now? I guess we're both alone. So we'd better stick together. Purr. I suppose I should give you a name. How about Dusty? You like that? Here, Dusty. Here, kitty kitty. What, you don't like it? I think it's a great name. Yeah, I'm not sure he's too happy about that either. And then a sweeping camera angle. And a bird flies past us. Was that a crow? Hey, Dusty, wait. Alright, so that's actually going to be it for this episode. Thank you all for watching the very first episode of Gravity Rush. Next time, we're going to go and follow Dusty, who is following a crow, and the crow might lead us to something important. So, I'll see you all next time.